filing for bankruptcy in 2001, Enron Corporation was one of the largest integrated natural gas and electricity company in the world. Enron Corporation is an energy trading and communication company based in Houston, Texas, employing around 21,000 people until June of 2001. It marketed natural gas liquid worldwide and operated totally more than 36,000 miles after a surge of growth in the early 1990s. The company runs into difficulty. The company had ranked number 7 on Fortune 500 and its failure was the biggest bankruptcy in American history. The firm European Corporation filed for bankruptcy on November 30, 2001 and sought bankruptcy protection in the US on December 2 of the same year. After a series of scandals involving irregular accounting procedures bordering on fraud involving its accounting firm Arthur Andersen, Enron stood at the verge of a neighboring and largest bankruptcy. Analysts of the case say, manager manipulated the intent and purpose of using special purpose entity, SPEs, by using them as a vehicle to hide debt and manipulate the parent company reported revenue and earnings.
First area of this is Enron use and misuse of balance sheet financing vehicle known as special purpose entity SPE. By the time Enron collapsed, it had created as many as 3,000 SPE. Accounting rules regarding SPE were designed for companies engaged in the sale and lease of physical assets. So, Enron really want to avoid to consolidate the financial of this SPE. In order to achieve that, each SPE had to meet three criteria. First, outside investor have at least 3% ownership. Second, the general partner of the SPE have to control the SPE in such a way that it does not act on behalf of the sponsor. Lastly, the SPE must possess the lion's share of the risk and rewards of ownership. As long as these criteria were met, Enron did not have to consolidate an SPE on its financial statement. Based on the observation, normally Enron use equity method of accounting for SPE. In other words, they simply added Enron proportional share in the earning of each SPE in a single line item on its income statement without disclosing corresponding balance sheet, cash flow and other considerations. So in this case, many of Enron SPE failed to fulfill these three criteria. So obviously, because the failure of SPE, the auditor could detect the fraud by Enron. One of the example in Chico transaction, Enron used SPE was to purchase assets from the parent company. By investing in project with the corporate balance sheet and then selling the asset to an SPE, Enron Corporation could book a gain on sale almost regardless of how the underlying asset performed. This process created the illusion of ongoing earning from this gain, which were booked repeatedly on the parent company's financial statement. Then, SPE carried the debt used to finance the deal, which would remain off balance sheet and undisclosed to Enron investors. This transaction seems much like a Ponzi scheme. The aggressive accounting technique combined with aggressive rules to maintain the illusion of success. In 2001, if I'm not mistaken, Enron reported a total debt of $10.2 billion. But the post-mortem analysis had revealed that Enron owed a total $22.1 billion, more than two times the reported amount. So, we can see clearly that Enron tried to hide the real amount of their debt. Actually, the Chico deal just was a landmark for Enron. In fact, it served as a model for a number of subsequent deals whereby Enron skirted disclosure and accounting conversion. As illustrated by the convoluted Chico deal, Enron was clearly using a balance sheet vehicle with the explicit intent of hiding asset and debt. It also creating a picture of a company that was performing much better than it actually was.
Another analyst mentioned that several corporate governance problems had emerged due to Enron case.
The role of a company's board of directors is to oversee corporate management in order to protect the interests of shareholders. However, in 1999, Enron's board waived conflict of interest rule to allow Chief Financial Officer Andrew Pastor to create private partnerships to do business with the firm. These partnerships appear to have concealed debts and liabilities that would have a significant impact on Enron's reported profit. During his tenure at Enron, Pastor earned $37 million just from these off-balance sheet financing deals. separate and distinct from his composition as CFO. His self-dealing was clearly unethical and also violated securities law and numerous regulations. Regarding Enron's fiscal year 2000 financial statements, one note refers to a related party transaction with a senior executive, but the note does not even state the cause of several corporate governance problems due to the Enron's breakage. Unfettered power in the hand of the chief executive is an obvious problem and is one that characterized Enron's management. Also, there were numerous illustrations of unethical activity within the Enron organization that continue to come to light long after its downfall. For example, in May 2002, it became clear from the documents released by the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission that Enron's energy traders development strategies or tricks to manipulate the market where California bought electricity.
The scandal involved a huge number of investors. Some of them include Alliance Capital and Citigroup, mentioned that they regret what happened to Enron.
Of Enron's biggest investor, which we are investing 43 millions of shares in Enron, and we are so disappointed due to the misleading of Enron financial statement and audit reports. Enron used SPE to create the illusion of ongoing earnings from gains, which were booked repeatedly on the parent company's financial statements. Apart from that, Enron does not disclose the debt used to finance the deal carried by SPE. The circumstances from their acts, we are suffered the largest losses on Florida State Pension Fund, which incurred loss of $334 million and $1 billion in clients' money from Enron only. Moreover, other impact on us is Florida State Board of Administration filed a security fraud lawsuit in response to $334 million loss Florida pension plan suffered under our financial management. The SBA aims to reduce over $300 million in damages incurred by what it claims were negligence event investment in Enron. However, we denied the fault by claiming that it was misleading Enron's financial statement. Unfortunately, we were charged by the court under breach of contract, breach of covenants, of good faith and fair deal. As an investor, we feel regret from what happened in Enron. They should present their financial statement and should involve stakeholders in making their decision. In addition, Enron should disclose all the matters happen in the company to avoid any conflict of interest.
As part of the shareholder in Enron, we feel disappointed for what happened between Arthur and Vasco. The audit as the management of the company did not show their full attention towards the problem faced. The BOD was not attentive to the nature of the off-books entities paid by Enron. Usually, the BOD did not pay attention to the employees because most of the directors consider their responsibility towards employees, but they always consider themselves representative of the shareholder or the owner. However, for this case, this BOD did not even represent the shareholders well. As the case happened, we had to settle and pay $2 billion to the Enron bankruptcy estate. This is because we had accused the Enron in fraudulent transactions made by Enron. To clean up the Enron mess, we estimate that we had paid more than $4 billion, including the settlement costs and lawyer fees for the legal process. Not only that, we also need to pay nearly $300 million in fines and penalties to settle accusations by the Securities and Exchange Commission and the Manhattan District Attorney's Office. Because of this, our share price fell by $1.34 to $22.13. According to FBI, which is the body that investigates Enron industry, more than $164 million was seized. 22 people have been convicted for the action related to the fraud, including Enron CEO, COO, CFO, and CFO.
Investigation in Enron cases have been conducted by the company's board, the Securities and Exchange Commission, and the Justice Department. FBI agents also participate in investigate Enron case. We've conducted more than 1,800 interviews and collected more than 3,000 boxes of evidence and more than 4 terabytes of digitized data. Justice Department has conducted the investigation in Aaron case with creating a task force of experienced prosecutors and FBI agents from around the nation to get the root of what happened and why. And the investigation throughout the company changed. For the special purpose entity have been conducted by the Special Investigate Committee of the Board of Directors of Aaron Corporation. The purpose of the special investigate is to address the transaction between Enron and investment partnership created by the Andrew Festo, which is special purpose entity. Based on the investigation, show that SPE is a related party transaction. But the committee only have limited resources, which they only can access a certain document in the workplace of Arthur Anderson, which is Enron external auditor. Therefore, Special Investigate Committee has examined 24 other transactions between Enron and this related party transaction. The investigate are focused on what this transaction, why they took place and what went wrong and who was responsible. Like have been informed by the case analyst Umi Nashra about the Chuko, one of the partnership in the SPE. Chuko were used by the Enron management to enter the transaction that unrelated with commercial entities. While Aaron case in perspective of corporate governance, we can see from the investigation that show the employee involved in the partnership were enriched in the aggregate by the $10 million. Like Andrew Festo, at least $30 million, Comber $10 million. Andrew Festo, which is Chief Financial Officer of Aaron Corporation, inconsistent with objective of fiduciary duties to Enron because he placed his own personal interest. He used his position in Enron to influence Enron employee who engaging in transaction and failed to disclose to Enron Board of Directors about the important information. So, Andrew Festo has alleged defraud Enron shareholder with entering into undisclosed side deals, manufacturing earnings for Enron through transaction and inflating the value of Enron investment.
Board of Directors should work for their shareholders, not for the CEO of the corporation. In Enron, we clearly see that a board not doing its job. An auditor should act independently in the transaction with the company being audited. However, in this case, Arthur Anderson received numerous amounts of money by helping in the organization of the SPE dealings, and this give bad perceived to professional body like Arthur Anderson itself. According to what had happened in Enron, FBI also advised that government regulations and rules need to be updated for the new economy, not relaxed and eliminated.